We initially first started this program, it's called our West Nile Virus Mosquito Management Program, back in 2003, because West Nile virus had first come to the United States in approximately 1999, and it was first found on the eastern coast of the United States and then advanced to the west. It was first found in Illinois in 2001, and then it progressively, we got more human cases and more mosquitoes tested positive, more birds died from the disease. So in 2003, the district decided to do an in-house program to prevent the spread of the disease and also to protect public health from the disease as well. It's also part of the district's mission to protect nature too. So we have kind of this dual mission with this program, to protect public health while also protecting the environment. Every week of the mosquito season, which usually starts late May, early June, we're going out to a select number of sites that we've predetermined that are either mosquito breeding sites or we've found the target of our management program, which is the Culex group of mosquitoes. And the Culex group of mosquitoes are the most common mosquitoes in Illinois that are able to transmit the disease to humans and other incidental hosts. So we're focused strictly on sites that can breed Culex. The sites that have, we have many water bodies in the county that have water but are not able to produce mosquitoes because they have natural predators like fish and dragonflies that eat mosquito larvae. We're not concentrating on those sites. We're concentrating on the sites that don't have natural predators or have very few natural predators, and thus they can breed more mosquitoes. So we're going to the sites that on a weekly basis that can produce Culex mosquitoes. We go out and actually collect water. If there are mosquitoes in that water, we'll identify those to see if there are Culex in that site. If there are Culex, we'll administer biologically derived larvicides to suppress the Culex population at that site. And every week we go back to the same sites and estimate whether or not they're breeding. And if they need additional treatments, we'll do that. We also have a separate group of sites where we monitor adult mosquitoes. And we test them, we collect adult mosquitoes and test them to see if they're actually positive or negative for West Nile virus too. So we do that on a weekly basis throughout the entire season, which is approximately 20 to 22 weeks. Human cases usually tend to accumulate later in the season. What happens is we have two main Culex mosquitoes, species of mosquitoes here. We have Culex restuans, which is more commonly found in the beginning of the season, and they tend to feed more on birds and not really on other hosts like humans. Culex restuans tends to start the viral cycle. And then we have a switch in abundance where Culex pipiens comes up like more in July, and then they're the more prevalent Culex mosquito for the remainder of the season. And because Culex pipiens feeds on birds, but it also feeds on humans and other hosts, it's more able to transmit the virus to humans and other incidental hosts. And that's why we tend to see human cases more in the later part of summer, late July, August, and September, and they tend to even accumulate into October. There are a lot of recommendations that come directly from the Illinois Department of Public Health. So first and foremost, wearing repellent actually is the single most thing that people can do to protect themselves from this disease. Repellent really works. Use the repellent as directed on the instructions. But repellent, also eliminating standing water, because Culex are a group of mosquitoes that tend to breed in containers. They breed really well in containers like neglected swimming pools, used tires, bird baths. And so if you have the opportunity to empty those standing water areas, it's really important to do that. They also call Culex pipiens the northern house mosquito. That's its common name. That tells you a little bit of something about where it really likes to breed. Around homes, around areas where there are a lot of containers that that hold water for the duration of the season. Also, stormwater catch basins are a really good habitat for Culex too. Many of the municipalities in DuPage County treat their stormwater catch basins with biologically derived larvicide. We also treat our catch basins proactively at the beginning of the season with a long-term larvicide, so we only have to treat it once for the whole 180 days of the season. Human behavior also tends to make people more exposed to the disease. Sometimes people like to, when it's really hot like how it is today, people like to take their morning and afternoon walks earlier, like closer to the dawn and dusk hours. That's precisely when Culex mosquitoes are most active. And so changing your behavior, using repellent, or walking a little bit later or a little bit earlier could help you prevent you from transmitting the disease. Also, if people are watering their lawns profusely, people tend to do that during drought years, that refills the catch basins in the street. So even in dry years, sometimes we have a lot of West Nile virus because people tend to do these kinds of activities that rehydrate a lot of the typical Culex habitats. And so simply changing human behavior, it's a difficult thing to do, but sometimes that can help immensely reducing the incidence of West Nile virus.